y'all hear that? Oh, frog songs are a sure sign of spring. I'm Ranger Lauri, and I think I'm going to go out and take a look and see if I can see who's singing to us today. Why don't you join me? Well, I have a few tools of the trade that I want to use when we're out in the field. So I have the smaller net for the little guys, and then I have a larger net. Maybe we'll get lucky and get a toad or a bullfrog. I also have a bottle of water. We're going to be by the pond, but it's important to keep our hands wet when we work with amphibians. We don't want them drying out. After all, they're an aquatic species. There's one now. Let's see if I can get him. All right, so it's important when you approach them to try not to scare them, because they're quick. So, I'm going to come up behind them quickly and carefully, try and net him. All right, here we go. Got him. Now it's important to leave the net all the way on the ground, because these little guys, they can slip out or hop out of the net. So I'm gonna wet my hands, and then I'm gonna give the our friend here an opportunity to get to the top of the net. I'm gonna close that section off, and I'm gonna carefully bring it up. And again, I wanna wet my hands. I'll bring my hand under, find a spot, got him. Now I wanna keep the net close by, because that's a far way to jump to the ground. And you're gonna notice that I have him down by his hips. I wanna avoid smushing his squishy parts. So all his vital organs are up here in his abdomen. And if you'll hold the frogs down here by the hips, their legs will relax, and you can get a good complete view of this animal for observation. And then I want to quickly and carefully let him go back to his natural environment. As rangers, we try to be very respectful of our resource and try not to do any harm ever. So I'm going to let him go, and it's important to let him go right where you got him. And I'm going to let him down on the ground, and then I'm going to carefully and quietly move back. Make sure you don't trip over anything. Ready? Welcome back. So we've got ourselves a tadpole. Now, we might not recognize this as a frog, but we want to take a look down in our net to see. I'm going to carefully move the little cone away, but we can see he doesn't, just starting to resemble a frog. He's got the frog body. He's using the tail for mobility. He's got no legs yet. They haven't emerged. So he's not a toadlet yet. He's simply a tadpole. By the judging of the size and some of the calls around the pond today, my best guess is that this is either a bullfrog or a green. But we've been hearing bullfrog calls this morning. So we're going to get him right back in the water quickly, because he's truly aquatic. All right. Got my eyes on a small one. Wish me luck. Success. All right. So I've got him in the net, and he's a small one, so he's a little trickier. Instead of getting all the way around, I'm going to come up here and see if I can invite him to visit with us. Let me get him turned around. So this is our cricket frog. We can look at this and tell by the markings on the side here, and he's got this really cool little V shape right between his eyes. It's kind of hard to see on the small one. But the cricket frog kind of sounds like angry crickets clacking. And I'll try and duplicate that sound. So we're going to let this guy head back into the pond and thank him for visiting with us. All right, so we're going to let our cricket frog go. So I'm just going to bring him back down here gently to the edge. And there he goes. See him swimming? So folks, I've got my eyes on, I think, either a pickerel or a leopard frog. Now I'm going to do my best to get him in the net, but it's pretty tight in here. Alright. Oh, I'm hung up on branches. Alright.
Got him.
Fantastic. Folks, I can't believe I caught him. So let me see if we can invite him. He's chirping quietly. All right. Make sure I've got him. Okay. So he's waving at us already. So as we look at this guy, we can see a lot of detail because he's a good size.
Hey Ranger Lauri, tell us what parts of the frog you're looking at when you're trying to figure out whether it's a pickerel or a leopard.
Well, it can be a little tricky in the field because not everything, just like us, not everybody looks the same. So I'm looking at these dorsal lines across the back, this big ear, that is the tympanum, and that's where his ear is, an inner ear, and then his eye. We're gonna come in a little closer to really check out frog eyes because they're pretty amazing. Come on in a little closer, and we're gonna take a real good look at his eye. Can y'all see that beautiful golden color? In nature, we rarely see metallics, and frog eyes are one of the most diverse places that we can see different shades of metallics. So we see golds, coppers, and bronze. I thought you'd want to hear the call of the leopard frog. And we are going to, this guy's been out of the water pretty long enough, so I'm going to go ahead and send him back home. I'm so glad you took an opportunity and had that chance to join us today. There were a few that we could hear and got our eyes on, but didn't get our nets on. So I wanted to share those with you before we end. The first one is the American bullfrog. Now we heard him, and Ranger Nicole and I saw him, but boy, he's quick and slippery. So when you hear this, that sounds like a bull in a field, doesn't it? So that's our American bullfrog, and they're mostly active right now. Nicole and I can hear them off in the distance. Another one that we enjoy but did not get to see today is the upland chorus frog. And their call is very unique. I'm going to show you a trick as how to remember their call. The chorus is the comb. Anybody recognize this? Maybe somebody's grandparent has the old plastic comb. Listen to this. Now hear the actual call of the recording. That is our upland chorus frog. Remember, the chorus is the comb. The last one we're going to highlight is our American toad. Now we might think that toad has kind of a toad-like call, but believe it or not, I'll let it surprise you. Listen to this. toads trill. So when you hear that beautiful soft trilling sound, you know you've got yourself an American toad nearby. Now, we talked earlier about their calls and why they were singing, and we know that they're singing to spot out territory and to look for a mate. But they are also singing these songs just for you. So take an opportunity and listen while you're around home or your neighborhood. When you can identify these calls, you know that these very important indicator species are singing a song for you, and they indicate the health of an entire ecosystem. And when we hear our frogs in the background, we know that the song they're singing just for us is that my habitat, our habitat, is healthy. And remember, it's not just rangers taking surveys in the field. You have an opportunity to contribute as a citizen scientist. If you hear this, that is the spadefoot toad. And he is listed as an endangered species here. When we hear those, we can contribute. You have an opportunity to contribute from your own neighborhood. Feel free to log on to this website for more information about spadefoot reporting. Become a citizen scientist today and join us. And remember, listen for those important frog calls. They're singing a song of health just for you. Thanks again for joining us.